The stage represents the backyard of Kushisamas, who are the richest family on the island. A mob prevents one from seeing more of the house than the high roof. Stands out sharply against the rich green sky in the southern island summer. At the left of the side, one catches the glimpse of the sea shining in the sunlight.
Yoshi is sitting on the roof again. He'll get a sunstroke. The sun terribly hot. Kichiji, where is Kichiji?
Yes, what do you want?
Bring Yoshitaro down. He has no hat on up there in the hot sun. He'll get a sunstroke. How did he get up there anyway? From the barn? Did you put wires around the barn roof?
Yes, I did exactly as you told me.
Yoshitaro, you'd better calm down. If you stay up there, you'll get a sunstroke and maybe die. Calm down right away. If you don't calm down, I'll get after you with a stick.
No, I don't want to. There's something wonderful. The priest of God Compere is dancing in the clouds. Dancing with an angel in pink robes. They're calling to me to come. Wait, I'm coming.
If you talk like that, you'll fall just as you did once before. You're already crippled and insane. What will you do next to worry your parents? Calm down, you fool.
Master, don't get so angry. The young master will not obey you. You should get some fried bean cake. When he sees it, he will calm down because he likes it.
No, you had better get the stick after him. Don't be afraid to give him a good shaking up.
That's too cruel. The young master doesn't understand anything. He's under the influence of evil spirits.
We may have to put bamboo guards on the roof to keep him down from there.
Whatever you do won't keep him down. Why? He climbed the roof of the Hanzen Tower without even a ladder. A low roof like this is one of the easiest things in the world for him. I tell you, it's the evil spirits that make him climb. Nothing can stop him.
You may be right. He worries me to death. If we could only keep him in the house, it won't be so bad.
That's just what I think. Otherwise, how could he climb trees so well? He can climb anything without a ladder. Even Saku, who's a professional climber, admits that he's no match for Yoshitaro.
Don't joke about it. It's no laughing matter. Having a son who is always climbing on the roof. Yoshitaro, calm down.
When I was a little girl, I remembered there was a ginkgo tree in front of the gate.
Yes, that was one of the biggest trees on the island. One day, Yoshitaro climbed clear to the top of the ginkgo tree and we never expected him to get down alive. But after a while, he slid.
That was certainly a miracle.
That's what I say. It's a monkey spirit that's working him. Kichiji, you'd better go up and fetch him.
But when anyone climbs up there, the young master gets angry.
Never mind, he's getting angry. Pull him down.
Yes, master.
Good day, sir.
Good day, fine weather. Catch anything with the nets you put out yesterday?
No, not much. The season's over. Your son on the roof again? But after all, he doesn't bother anybody.
He bothers us. We feel ashamed when he climbs up there and shouts.
But your younger son, Sajiro, has to find regular school. That must be some consolation for you.
Yes, he's a good student and that is a consolation for me.
By the way, a priestess has just come to the island. How would you like to have her pray for your son? That's really what I came to see you about.
We've tried prayers before but it's never done any good.
This priestess believes in God Compira. She works all kinds of miracles. People say to God inspires her. That's why her prayers have a more effect than those of ordinary priests. Why don't you try her once?
Well, we might. How much does she charge?
I won't take your money unless the patient is cured. If he's cured, you can pay her whatever you feel like.
Sayiro says he doesn't believe in prayers, but there's no harm in letting him try.
I will go and fetch her here. In the meantime, you get your son down off the roof.
Thanks for your trouble.
Now then, young master, come down with me. If you stay up here any longer, you'll have a fever tonight.
Don't touch me. The angels are beckoning me. You are not supposed to come here. What do you want?
Don't talk nonsense. Please, come down. Don't make any trouble now. If you do, you'll fall and hurt yourself.
Be careful. Ayoshi, come out here for a minute.
What is it?
I've sent for a priestess.
That may help. You never can tell what will happen.
Yoshitaro says he talks with the god Kompira. Well, this priestess is a follower of Kompira, so she ought to be able to help him.
Father! Why did you bring me down? There was a beautiful cloud of 5 colors rolling down to fetch me.
Idiot! Once before you said there was a 5-colored cloud and you jumped off the roof.
It's the priestess I spoke to you about.
Ah, good afternoon. I am glad you've come. This boy is really a disgrace to the family.
You don't need to worry about him. I'll cure him at once with God's help.
Ever since he was burned up until now, he loves climbing up in different places.
There's no doubt, but it's a fox spirit. I will pray for him. Listen, now. I am the messenger of the god Kompira.
You see the god Kompira? Have you ever seen him? I have seen him many times. He's an old man with white robes and a golden crown. He's my best friend.
I am the god Kompira. The elder son of this family is under the influence of a fox spirit. Hang him up on the branch of a tree and purify him with the smoke of green pine needles. If you fail to do what I say, you will all be punished. What happened? Did the god speak?
It was a miracle.
You must do at once whatever the god told you, or you'll be punished. I warn you for your own sake.
Kichiji, go and get some green pine needles.
No, it's too cruel, even if it is the god's command. He will not suffer. Only the fox spirit within him. The body himself will not suffer at all. Hurry, did you hear the god's command? He told the spirit to leave your body before it hurts.
That was not Kompira's voice. He won't talk to a priestess like you.
I'll get even with you. Just wait. Don't talk back to the god like that, you horrid fox. Respect the god or be punished.
Father, what are you doing to me? I don't like it.
That's not his own voice speaking. It's the fox within him. Only the fox is suffering.
But it's cruel.
What's happening here? What's the smoke for? Father, what foolish thing are you doing now? Haven't I told you time and time again about this sort of business? What nonsense is that? You do these insane things merely because he is so helpless.
Soijiro, I have no education and you have. I am always willing to listen to you, but this fire was made at the god's command, and you should have stepped on it.
Smoke won't cure him. People will laugh at you if they hear you've been trying to drive out a fox. All the gods in the country together couldn't even cure a cold. This is priestess is a fraud. All she wants is the money.
But the doctors can't cure him.
If the doctor can't, nobody can. I told you before that he doesn't suffer. If he did, we'd have to do something for him. But as long as he can climb up on the roof, he is happy. Nobody in the whole country is as happy as he is. Perhaps nobody in the world. Besides, if you cure him now, what can he do? He's 24 years old. He knows nothing, not even the alphabet. He's had no practical experience if he were, cause he will be conscious of being crippled. And he'd be the most miserable man alive. Is that what you want to see? It's all because you want to make him normal, but wouldn't it be foolish to become normal? Merely to suffer. Tosaku, if you brought her here, you had better take her away.
You disbelieve the oracle of the god. You will be punished.
That's a damn lie. You all fall. You fraud. You swindler.
Young man, don't get in such a frenzy.
You liar. A woman like you can understand brotherly love.
I'll leave you now. It was my mistake to have a brat.
I hope you'll excuse him. He's young and has such a temper.
You kicked me when I was inspired by the god. You'll be lucky to survive until tonight.
Liar!
Be still now.
I am sorry this happened.
The foot you kicked me will rot off.
Aren't you afraid of being punished for what you've done?
A god never inspire a woman like this old swindler. She lie about everything.
I suspected her from the very first. She wouldn't do such cruel things if a real god inspired her.
Maybe so, but Sergio, your brother will be a burden to all your life.
It will be no burden at all. When I become successful, I build a tower for him on the top of a mountain.
But where's Yoshitaru gone?
He's up there.
A normal person will be angry with you for having to put him in the smoke, but you see he's forgotten everything. Yoshitaru!
Tijiro, I asked Kompira and he says he doesn't know her.
You're right, the god will inspire you, not a priestess like her. What a beautiful sunset.
Tijiro, look! Can't you see a golden palace in that cloud over there? There! Can't you see? Just look! How beautiful!
Yes, I see! I see it too! Wonderful!
There, I hear music coming from the palace. Flutes, what I love best of all. Isn't it beautiful?
The story is written by the Japanese playwright Kikuchi Kan, known as the Tycoon of the Literary World. The plot basically revolves around a father who is concerned about his 24-year-old son who climbs on the roof to watch the sunset. His dad was worried that his son is special and will hurt himself and embarrass the family. His brother helps them realize that as long as his brother doesn't hurt himself, let him enjoy the sunset. In other words, a madman who is able to enjoy the beauty of a sunset is far better off than the fully sane man who doesn't. The story reminds us that we must love our family, especially those with special needs. We must be the one to understand what they really feel. We must take responsibility and we must love our family unconditionally.